Coal corrosion can be significantly damaging over a very short period of time. In traditional terms, we would be looking at the cylinder componentry and liners lasting upward of 80 or 100,000 hours. With severe coal corrosion that's not addressed by correct cylinder oil, you can damage a liner beyond useful life in under 10,000 hours.
More challenging legislation under constant pressure to keep fuel consumption down mean the demands placed on marine engines have never been greater. However, in meeting these demands, what happens inside the engine has significantly changed. Acid formulation is an inevitable part of diesel combustion. At low levels, it aids lubrication and can be managed. But adapting to a changing environment presents two tough challenges. Emission controls, which lead to varying operating conditions and fuels in use. The design of engines that deliver increased fuel efficiency through longer stroke and lower RPM for efficient slow steaming.
Slow steaming is now becoming normal steaming, and what we see over the last year or so is that new ships are coming out with engines that are right-sized for what would previously be called a slow steaming service is the steaming service. So the engine is smaller in horsepower capacity, and as a result, it's running at a higher load regime.
The latest generation slow-speed engines combine lower emissions and better fuel economy by running at part or very low loads, but at a cost.
The factors that have made coal corrosion an issue more recently are the fact that engine designers are chasing ever higher efficiency from a CO2 perspective. To do this, they've increased pressures within the cylinders of the engine, and this alters the dew point of the sulfuric acid within the cylinder. And even at very high temperatures and very high pressures, condensation can happen on the liner wall, resulting in coal corrosion.
Sulfuric acid causes increased wear of engine components and scours and pits the cylinder lining, dramatically reducing its lifespan by as much as 90%. And it's not only the combustion area that's at risk. In severe cases, some engines suffer cold corrosion around the scavenge inlet ports. So what's to be done? To combat corrosion for two-stroke engines, identifying the optimum cylinder lubricating oil feed rate is paramount. This should be established by monitoring using tools such as ExxonMobil's next-generation Mobil Serve Cylinder Condition Monitoring Service.
It's critical that engineers on board the ship actually understand the engine's needs and ensure that the engine's in a low wear regime and that it's being correctly lubricated. Programs such as our Mobil Serve Cylinder Condition Monitoring Program ensure that the engineer understands exactly what is happening from a lubrication perspective. The two key parameters that we analyse are the total iron content of the scraped down oil. This ensures that we don't have excessive iron and we understand exactly that the engine is in a low wear condition. And we also measure the total base number of the oil, or TBN. This shows us that we've got an alkalinity reserve in the scraped down oil, so that we're not in a position where coal corrosion is occurring.
For corrosive engines using high sulfur fuel, a high BN cylinder oil is required, whereas for engines deemed to be non-corrosive, a mid-range BN cylinder oil is required. Combating cold corrosion requires rigorous engine room management. Key activities include determining the appropriate cylinder oil and feed rate, regular onboard cylinder oil analysis as recommended by leading engine manufacturers, engineering support from your lube oil supplier for cold corrosion detection and mitigation. In the next program, CAT fines, we'll look at what these are, how they enter the fuel train, and how you can stop them stop your engine. For more information about how to mitigate cold corrosion, please visit ExxonMobil.com/marine.